Superior and inferior mesenteric branches. In terms of landmarks to start off with, I'll just put a label here for transverse colon. Down in the bottom left is the cecum. Then from the cecum we have the descending colon. And why don't we go ahead and put our list down of mid-gut structures. All right, zooming in on the mid-gut here. We should find branches to small intestines. Thank you. Small intestines. As well as ascending and transverse colon. Cecum. And appendix. So these midgut derived structures will be taken care of by the superior mesenteric artery, which I would like to draw for you now. Put a circle in, a red circle, I'm back to red now. And I'll just put SM inside this circle to denote superior mesenteric artery. And superior mesenteric artery is going to descend and go to the right side of the body. So let's put some of these branches in from proximal to distal. I just finished the last drawing with this vessel here. So we saw how the superior pancreatico-duodenal anastomosis with the inferior pancreatico-duodenal. This is where the inferior pancreatico-duodenal comes from. It is a branch of the superior mesenteric artery. Inferior pancreatico-duodenal. There will be several branches coming off of the superior mesenteric artery that we just refer to as intestinal branches. And by that I mean small intestine. So jejunal, and ileal. I-L-E-A-L. Okay, we don't need to count them or number them or anything crazy like that. They are just branches off of the superior mesenteric artery. We will find branches that are swinging out toward the colon. So the middle colic artery. That will take care of the transverse colon. And so, I mean, that's probably doing some ascending colon and some right hepatic flexure, but primarily we think of middle colic as coming up and hitting the transverse colon. There's also the right colic. Right colic artery is going to primarily take care of the ascending colon. And this terminal end of the superior mesenteric artery is the ileocolic artery. So I'm drawing these anastomotic connections because you can think of these as like fairly large arcades. They're just big loops of arteries. So you're going to identify the right colic as the artery going to the ascending colon. You're going to identify the middle colic as the artery going to the transverse colon. You're going to identify the ileocolic as the artery going to the cecum. And you know, why not? Let's just draw a little appendix in there. That sounds like fun. There we go. And that should take care of our checklist of midgut. Small intestines, got that in terms of intestinal branches. Ascending and transverse colon, got that. Cecum and appendix, got that. The inferior mesenteric is very simple. We could definitely do it in 2 minutes. I'm just going to come over to the right side here and put in another circle. Put in IM for inferior mesenteric. And I'm going to drop the inferior mesenteric artery down. Inferior mesenteric does hindgut structures. So let me go ahead and grab the black here and refresh your memory as to what comprises the hindgut. Descending colon. Transverse colon. Sigmoid colon. And the rectum. Okay, back to red for inferior mesenteric artery. Ascending toward the transverse colon is the left colic artery. And I did draw an anastomosis of the left colic with the middle colic. That is happening at the transverse colon. Now, the left colic is also looping out. I didn't quite demonstrate this properly, but it is going to take care of the descending colon as well. So know that you're going to be redrawing these, and what I would do if I were you is I would draw the left colic sweeping out to the left to the descending colon to go up to the transverse colon, almost like we had with the middle colon. There are several sigmoid arteries off of the inferior mesenteric. And the inferior mesenteric artery terminates as the superior rectal artery. And let's do our checklist of hindgut. We've got descending colon from left colon, as well as transverse colon through left colic, sigmoid colon from sigmoid branches, and rectum through superior rectum. And that summarizes the branches of the inferior and superior mesenteric arteries. I'm going to stop Panopto, send you on your way, and hang out in case I can help clarify anything else.